And probably drink some water. Well, I don't really think that was Goat's fault. That was... Well, okay, the only, like, dumb thing that happened during that fight is at one point, I tried to jump off one of the ramps as Goron Link, but Goron Link just, like, stayed stuck to the ground for some reason, which is bad during that fight, because you want to hit Goat as Goron Link while you're in the air, because that immediately knocks Goat down. So thank you for the good luck again, Fisalino. And thank you for the good luck as well, Cassie and Real Major Bruno. Well, like, where specifically are you talking about Katamon? Are you talking about, like, on speedrun.com, on Gymbot, on my splits, like... As far as, at least, I think all those places are updated properly. As far as I'm aware. Well, no, on my splits it's correct, because the PB from the other day was only a PB by 1.5 seconds. So, like, my previous PB was a 209.34. Also, thank you for the good luck, great vids. Well, yeah, my PB did fail the cutscene skip, but I was too far behind at that point in, like, the previous run to want to continue, basically. For the good luck hero of time. But yeah, I understand the confusion, Katamon. Also, because of the fact that, like, the time save that I get for skipping the, Snowhead cutscene would have, like, if I go down to my splits, I split for Goat when I get the remains, regardless of, like, if I skip the cutscene or not, so... the Great Spin Attack split is where I can actually save the time, for, like, getting the cutscene skip, basically. Yeah, it would be nice if there was, like, a good way to put that time save into, like, the Goat split, but... Eh. I'd rather split on getting the remains. What a baby Deku looks like. Yeah, I don't know. Also, hello, Jack Watcher. The one previous attempt I had a nice start, but then kind of fell apart when I got to the temples. So hopefully we can have a nice start and then not fall apart. Get excited when resets happen. Feels like endless potential. That's an interesting viewpoint. Can't say I've ever thought about resets like that, but that is true in a sense. Okay, so I need to update gym lot. Ah, okay, I see, Azertharian. I mean, yeah, that's true, you know. Every new run that you do is a chance to learn new things. So, whatever attempt you're currently on, is the attempt that does have the most likely potential to be your best run. Also, thank you for the good luck, Audio Killers. Sidon probably would tell me good luck. Vennec has this really cool Sidon shirt, which is just Sidon giving the thumbs up and the smile, saying, "You can do it." It's a very good shirt. Any other games I'm looking forward to other than the Breath of the Wild sequel? I'm definitely looking forward to Splatoon 3. Well, it'll probably be fun to play with friends. Wish we could get a little more information about it. Or at least on, like, when it's gonna be released. Oh, I think you're, like, doing fine, little Tanuki. Dog water meta. Oops. I'd like to do a side hop. Well, they did give a release date of, or at least a tentative release date of 2022. During, like, the one Splatoon 3 teaser that we got. Which actually showed us, like, quite a lot of stuff. As far as, like, weapons and sub-weapons go. Also, yes, I am still at the speedruns. Been going since 2013, and, well, I'll probably be going as long as I can. Happens when you press B one too many times. Hoping that Splatoon 3 comes out, like, sometime at least a few months before the Breath of the Wild sequel releases. Because if, like, it releases around when the Breath of the Wild sequel releases, I'm probably not going to be playing it a whole lot. Yeah, the new Kirby game does look kind of fun. I don't know if I'll be getting it myself, but... it does look like it will be a nice, pleasant game to play. Hopefully we'll get, like, another Nintendo Direct soon. Ah, darn it. Four pauses. We got one in, like, the middle of February last year, if I'm recalling correctly. This is, like, when we learned about Skyward Sword HD and all that jazz. Pretty sure the game that I played most as a kid had to have been Roller Coaster Tycoon. That was definitely my escape game. Playing all three versions. I'm not really sure which one was my favorite, though. Probably either two or three. Unfortunately, the extra pause buffers and the, like, five attempts at doing the twisted backflip lost us some time. I know Point Crow. I know of Point Crow, but I have never talked to Point Crow. Ah, yes, part of the watch speedruns to go to sleep gang. So hello, Walla. I do still think it's like, it's sort of mildly funny to me that, like, there are quite a lot of people who, use my content to fall asleep to. I mean, just given the nature of the content, it makes sense, but... Like, if you told me back in 2013 that, you know... I would be making speedrun content that people, or not everybody, of course, but that, like... Some group of people will use to fall asleep to, I'd be very confused. Why people would fall asleep watching speedruns. Granted, I myself have almost fallen asleep watching speedruns a few times. Although usually those are like in-person runs. Like I've definitely almost fallen asleep like in the GDQ stream room before. But managed to stay awake. I also almost fell asleep at Pace, 2019. Very good Linquid. Well, right, I mean... Like, at least just the... Like, my personality doesn't really lend itself to, like... A hype stream, really. It's more just like, hello, I'm Gymnast, I'm going to play video games. And occasionally insert dry humor into things. And my voice is also, like, really deep, so... That also helps. Who would fall asleep in the GDQ stream room? I wonder. Gotta moisturize that humor. Ah, I see, yes. Gotta go buy my humor moisturizer. Alright, Linquid, good night. Hope that you get some peaceful rest. Gymnast ASMR. There was one, when was it? I think it was a stream, back in 2018 where, like, I did a Skyward Sword Any% speedrun, which back then was around 5 hours. And then after that run, which I don't think PB'd, I just decided to do another one, except during that entire run, I, like, intentionally tried to make my voice as ASMR-ish as possible while explaining everything. That was a really interesting run. I'm not even sure what prompted that. I was just like, yeah, this feels like something I want to do. I gotta scream really loud at a random time to give the sleepers a heart attack. I don't know about that one. I feel like that would be kind of rude. Got our bomb drop. Oh, that's actually pretty good, Solid Bones. I didn't know that ZFG did that. And it makes sense just because of, like, the crash noise. And that I imagine since SRM crashes are a lot more common now. Although usually the crashes in the games that I do, like, don't result in the loud crash noise because they're not, like, N64 or GameCube games. Or if there is, or if it is, like, a GameCube game, it usually doesn't crash. Because Wind Waker doesn't tend to crash a whole lot unless you're doing, like, something that you're intending to make crash. Also, thank you for the good luck, Al. And hello, lovey Kina. Hope that the studying is going all right. My run attempts have been kinda eh, but hopefully this one can be a little bit better. We did thankfully get good bomb RNG. I suppose we could do a Fess using the tech type, but the Fess wouldn't really save much time. And would be difficult to do. You can't really Hess in this game. Other than, like, out of water. Which then would be a Wess. Because forward extended super slide speed isn't a whole lot faster in this game. It's not generally worth it. Like, he's made of helium. He does go very far. Yeah, my 3DS still has the circle pad rubber. thank you for the good luck, Mandato. Also, yes, we are indeed green again. That segment was, pretty okay. I've definitely heard of, like, people's 3DS circle pad rubber falling off before, but that's never happened for me. I feel like generally, at least, I'm, like, not as aggressive with my controllers, and I guess in this case with, like, the 3DS buttons as it seems like most other people are. Like, there was one night where me, Venik, and Zeilu were, like, all sort of, like, comparing the mashing styles that we use, for, like, our GameCube controllers, and also just, like, the way that we handle our GameCube controllers, like, for, you know, like, GameCube games. And, like, some of the ways that, like, Venik and Zeilu were, like, being aggressive with their controller kind of, like, surprised me, because I was like, I never get that aggressive with my controllers. So maybe that's why my circle pad rubber is still on. I didn't break the stick. Ah, well, that's why ESS bottle duping doesn't work if you have ammo. I knew I was forgetting something earlier. Yeah, in the 3DS version, we can just mash the B button to climb really fast. A little strange, but it works. And also just, you know, saves time. Thank you. Yeah, you can just kind of backflip onto that door frame. Saves a nice bit of time. Because you can skip having to go through, like, all of Deku Palace. Just get straight up to where the monkey is. Unfortunately, we only saved 4 seconds of the 30 seconds that we could have saved. Or I guess closer to 3 seconds. So welcome to the stream, Jojo Pipe. And you're enjoying the speed content. Where we attempt to go fast, but don't always succeed. But that's okay. I guess the rolling was really clean. Now let's see if we can have a good pirate's fortress this time. Which is my favorite stray fairy? I don't know. I think my favorite one that we get in the speedrun is the one that we, clip out of bounds and then do a bow clip to shoot an underwater, sun for. Stone Tower Temple. Hello? Okay, well, I thought that I pressed the 2 button on the touchscreen, but apparently I didn't. So now I guess we're watching the cutscene. As Gronlink, who is too tall. Jump. I think you're definitely supposed to make millions of tacos. Hmm. That is not straight. That is also not straight. Surprisingly, it was too far to the right, which usually does not happen. Usually, if I'm not straight during a downward Goron missile, it's because I was too far to the left. Be losing time on Great Fairy Mask again. Door swimming sounds like swishing water in your mouth. I can kind of see that. I don't think that's an association that I would have made, though. But I could, it does kind of vaguely sound like it. So hello, Lloyd. Also, hey, Zilinky. Thank you for the good luck. I'm not sure how much different this game would really be if we could do ISG. Although I say that because it doesn't have ISG, so I probably don't understand what the full implications would be, at least in some circumstances. Especially because we do have glitches, like Goron Missile in this run. I even turned on the 3D. Also, thank you very much for the good luck, Restless Bard. Yes, we did have all three dimensions up and running. Right, so I have to remember that this time I don't need to actually check the woodfall owl. Because it's not necessary for anything. To play OOT 3D Rando on a 3DS. Yeah, it was... Like, the OOT 3D Randomizer was specifically designed with being able to play it on a 3DS in mind. Basically, you just, if you haven't already, you would need to first homebrew your 3DS, which typically isn't very difficult, at least these days it's not. And then you basically just load up the randomizer as a homebrew application, or an installed CF file. And then you generate the randomizer, and the homebrew, like, does everything for you. And you just open up OOT 3D. If you're not in the OOT 3D randomizer Discord, I would definitely recommend joining it, because there's, like, a more in-depth guide there that I can't, like, recite word for word while I'm doing a run. So thank you for the good luck, Nessie. Well, yeah, I'm pretty sure you can homebrew, like, any kind of 3DS. Because I'm pretty sure the steps are all the same. The only thing that really matters is, like, what firmware you currently have. Do I have the Guinness World Record for this category? Well, currently I have the world record, but, like... Speedrunning isn't associated with, like, Guinness or anything, because we don't really care what they think. Oops. almost missed. To the bubble. That might be too high, but thankfully it wasn't. Was highly convenient. And we got a best segment by about 6 frames. Also, thank you for the good luck, Camp Creek. Yeah, if you wanted to, you could just, like, get the bow. from Woodfall and leave and then go beat Snowhead first, technically. That is entirely possible. Took a little bit longer than usual to fly up to Link. It is a long time to have been following the channel, at least relatively. A good almost 7 years, or roughly 7 years. I mean, you're not obliged to, like, subscribe or chat if you don't want to. Like, you can just follow, and that's perfectly fine. Or you can do nothing. we do the, once again, very exciting block pushing. Also, hey, Selgi, thank you very much for the good luck. Get Snowhead cutscene skip or not. Not slide off again. Oh, what the heck? I don't know how that missed, but... For the good luck, Pidgey, you. I suppose at some point I should probably switch to doing the faster boss key skip here. Also, thank you for the good luck as well, Virus. Been in here on that first one. Also, hello, Rotor Cowboy. Not a very good goat fight. I would like to be. I definitely lost a bunch of time on that fight. At least 15 seconds or so. At least we did the thing, though. Yeah, we can still get a better best on Goat there. We'll be saving a minute and 49 seconds on this segment now. Or something around there. Decent cutscene skip.
Good start to this segment.
hopefully have a good Great Bay. And then follow up the good Great Bay with a good Stone Tower. And then not lose 40 seconds on Majora. Good. Thank you. also looking back in it. I already got this one. Well, thank you very much for the 10 bits net. Okay, I think we actually had an okay, at least fairy collecting part of Great Bay. Oh my goodness. Get back there. Now, hopefully, Georg cooperates. I probably should have just shot that with an arrow. There's no way I'm making it back to Georg right here. Okay, well that works. Well, SRM is not allowed in this category, so the only way that we can get to the moon is by beating the bosses. And collecting the remains. Alright. Big time save coming up here. Very big time save. So thank you very much, Nick, for the purple ruby. Or the big time save celebration. But yeah, that was a best by, like, a minute and 15 seconds-ish. Because we actually did Great Bay correctly for once, or at least mostly correctly. There were still a few things that were kind of slow, but overall it was, like, not too bad. For the 5 bits as well, plum sweater. Now we get our double defense. Hopefully have a nice segment up to the light arrows. But the light arrow segment is definitely tricky, so... we will have to play well. So thank you for the good luck, Cyrodiil. Great start. Really high. Unfortunately, I would have preferred that, but... so that's unfortunately going to be a time loss. Yeah, the fountains, like, they didn't change that map data. I mean, there wasn't really a reason to, because from a casual gameplay perspective, it didn't really make a whole lot of difference. Scripted items to put on the Deku mask underwater. Sacred dance. It is a very good dance. I believe you can use ZL and ZR as just regular L and R buttons in MMO3D. At least you could if you had the Circle Pad Pro, like an original 3DS. A little bit of time here, which sucks because this definitely means we could have saved even more time on light arrows. Like 30 seconds before we even entered into the temple here. Is 3DMM any good? Depends on who you ask. I think it's pretty good. Underwater ledge climb. Unfortunately, that was kind of slow. To jump a little bit farther. Also, thank you for the good luck, Felix. Bit unfortunate. Sure, I like the non-inverted stone tower thing slightly more. Thank you. that's not very far out. Out here and then back in. And hope that this works. Okay, good. Alright, well, my favorite Zelda game is a tie between Wind Waker and Skyward Sword in general. This is the intended way of entering the boss room. Was pretty decent. Also, thank you for the good luck, Blendra. This run do be ahead, and hopefully stays ahead. This is preferred. Theopany adaptations are, like, really good. Probably my favorite adaptations of, Zelda music in general. Positioning kind of sucks. Deal with it. Hey! Alright, very good. So thank you for the blue rupee again, Plum Sweater. But yeah, so, pretty decent. Well, I mean, we still had like a 30-second time loss on light arrows, which was kind of bad. And even on the Twin Mold segment, there were still some things that weren't desirable. Which we could have saved more time with, but we did get really lucky in the Twin Mold fight itself, like with how, blue Twin Mold's, like, RNG patterns were. Also, thank you for the good luck, Mopey. But yes, hopefully the RNG is with us. I shall also remember to actually go and get, the fairy reward. This is the bell that summons good RNG. Oh boy. The good RNG bell. We do like ourselves a good RNG bell. Accidentally shoot too far up into the sky this time during the Goron missile. The music is indeed going fast. That's okay though. Thank you for the good luck, Billy Bob the Butter. This is a very bright sky. What happened to Goat? Goat was fine. Well, actually, I could have saved like another 10 to 15 seconds on Goat, but, I only lost like 3 frames on Goat compared to my PB. What is this copypasta? I haven't heard of this one, or I haven't seen this one before. Jimothy is in great danger, and he needs your help to get 2 more followers on Twitch. To help him, all he needs is your credit card number, the 3 digits on the back, the expiration month and year, and for you to follow him. But you gotta be quick, so Jimothy can secure the bag and get 100 followers before 2023. Excellent. This has very 2014 copypasta energy to it. Also, yes, 2023 is next year. I don't know, 2 followers is a tall order. I don't know if I'll be able to reach that. But I'm gonna do my best. Also, thank you for the good luck chest slap. But yes, it's time... It's finally time for the hopefully not bad RNG fest to begin. Jimothy the second. So if we're lucky, Incarnation's just gonna run right into my great spin attack right away. Okay, well this also works. A little bit slow, but we'll take it. This is a weird spot in the arena, though. What? We got the 10 hits in. Without too much stupid stuff happening. And so now we got a 205.40. Which, all things considered, not too bad, I think. Also, thank you very much for the 100 bits, Joshua. Thank you very much, Nat, for the 100 party bits as well. And thank you guys all very much for the GGs. But yes, this is a new record for all fairy rewards. Beats the previous one by almost 4 minutes, because we actually had like a good Great Bay Temple for once. To waste. Well, this run will be harder to beat, but it's still definitely beatable, I would say. Definitely was not, like, a perfect run or anything. Especially, like, near the beginning, there's a lot of time that can be saved. But yeah, so, like, Ocarina... 1904 is not great. That's like 12 seconds off of my best. Gorham S segment was fine. Unfortunately, I lost like 25 seconds on Sonata because, what happened? Because, I failed to ESS dupe because I didn't break my stick accidentally. Zora Mask was fine, and then on Hookshot, I missed the Pirates cutscene skip. So, that's why we lost time there. Great Fairy Mask, also not too great. I lost like 20 seconds over best. Oh, I lost 10 seconds. Actually, I think that was 25 seconds over best I lost there. But then Odawa was fine for the most part. Fire Arrows was fine. Goat was fine. We got the cutscene skipped, so we saved a lot of time on Great Spin Attack. Great Bay was fine. Light Arrows I lost like more than 30 seconds on because I failed the Goron Missile into Stone Tower. And then Twin Mold was fine, and Majora was mostly fine. So, that was that run. Also, thank you very much, Kit Kat, for the raid party of 7. And thank you for the GGs also. So this run is still definitely beatable. Just requires actually having, like, you know, a good Great Bay and... well, I guess good temples in general. Yeah, unfortunately, Twitch notifications are sometimes a little late, Nini. The best way to get notified would be to, like, join the Discord and give yourself the stream alerts role so that you get Discord notifications when I go live. Because Discord notifications are never late. Or at least they're never late for me. But yeah, Twitch notifications, kind of bad sometimes. Ah, I see Fierce Vinegar. Well, I hope you had a good time at the cinema. But yeah, so that was, I think that's probably, where I'll stop for all fair rewards, I think. I could still improve this time, but I kind of want to just run Wind Waker all dungeons. And this seems like a decent enough PB to end on. But the 22 attempts that I did at this category were very fun. Yerbal or Riot? I don't think I'll be running Talk to Yerbal. Well, yeah, today's sum of best started at about a 204, I think.
Something like that.
But yeah, we had a huge best in Great Bay because I just actually had, like, a good Great Bay for once. Yeah, so for those of you who don't know, Wind Waker All Dungeons got a pretty big break recently with the discovery of Early Earth Temple, which cuts out needing to go to Hyrule 2, which is pretty big. And so it ends up saving like more than 10 minutes in the category. Because you skip all the Hyrule 2 cutscenes and also... you skip having to learn the Earth God's Lyric and, like, teaching the Earth God's Lyric to Medley, which is also a very long cutscene, so... It's now all dungeons with less cutscenes, which is what we like to see. Because Wind Waker has too many cutscenes. But yeah, so I believe that will be it for the stream today. Tomorrow we'll probably attempt to learn all dungeons. See if we can figure some things out, because there are some new tricks that we also have to learn for other than the early Earth Temple clip. There are some other new tricks that we have to learn as well for the route. So that will probably be the plan for tomorrow, which means that this is probably the last MM3D run that I will be doing for a while. But I'll probably be submitting, like, no wrong warping all fairy rewards to, like, future GDQs. So if it gets accepted into a future GDQ, we'll play it again. But with that, I believe I will be seeing you all later, and tomorrow probably, at 2 p.m. Eastern for some Windy Wakey. I can't believe this is Jim's last stream ever. No, hopefully that doesn't happen for a while. But anyway, I will see you guys later. Bye-bye.